Herculi Products. Herculi Products is a fabric company specializing in laminated and coated products for over 60 years. They're labeled as one of the top fabric companies in the world, and they actually pioneered the use of laminated fabrics in the healthcare industry, such as the hospital bedding and sheets, and they also make a lot of body bags, which was a little weird. They also have one of the most extensive product testing databases in the industry, including the Clark Stiffness Tester, which is actually a military-grade test, and only two companies in the world have it. It's pretty much they want to see the stiffness of the fabric, so you put the fabric in a clamp, and then it flips it back and forth, and you measure the length of the fabric once it hits 45 degrees. And just recently, one of their customers needed a fabric that they didn't make, so the team needed to develop a fabric with the aesthetic features of natural fabric with the benefits of polymer technology. So they actually made their own fabric known as Herculi Natura, and it's been called the most innovative high performance fabric in a generation. So that was really cool to see and test those products. My internship responsibilities included learning the basic areas in quality control. So there's a lot of tests that I never really would have thought would be done on fabrics. They have to do a burn test to make sure that they don't burn for too long or that they don't have too much char when they burn, because they make a lot of outdoor products such as tents and awnings, so a lot of stuff around campfires. And then I also learned the different tests that they did on the fabric, with a big emphasis on the weights and the bonds of the products, because that's what most of my internship was spent analyzing. And the bonds is they actually fold the fabric in half and then they weld it together, and then they pull it apart and you try and pull the fabric down. And if the fabric pulls down, then they then put it in a different machine, which tests the pounds that it takes to pull the fabric apart. And then I also did data entry and other miscellaneous chores that are normal for an internship, filing, organizing filing cabinets, that kind of stuff. And then the bulk of my internship was spent creating summary statistics and trendline graphs for each product made by the company, which was over 150 different products that they make. And then I would also analyze the graphs once I made them. So this is an example of the summary statistics, which the adhesion face and the adhesion reverse, which are the top two, I know it's hard to see, were the bonds. They call them adhesion or bonds, it just depends. And the weight were the three that I was focused on, because they actually had TriVantage is one of their major customers. Over 70% of their products are sent out to TriVantage, and they almost lost them because they were making cost cuts and were changing the glue used in the products, and so the bonds were actually getting too weak. So most of my job was just to make sure that over the past 3 years the bonds haven't gotten weaker, because they don't want to lose any more customers. But I would look at the expected min for the adhesion face and the adhesion reverse and compare it to the average value that was seen, and if it was above, then they were good. And then I did that for January to June, and then July to December for 2015, 2016, and the first half of 2017. And then I will compare and see if they increased or decreased, or how they compared for the 6 month increments. And I would also do the same with the And then this is an example of one of the weight graphs. It has all of left, center, and right that are cut out. They cut them out either up and down or horizontal, depending on which fabric they're using. And so the blue line, that's the min, and the red line's the max. So that one stayed in between those, so it looks like a good one. And then for the adhesion face, the min is the blue line at the 4, and as long as they were above, then that was good and they passed. And same for the reverse. It's at the 1, because if they didn't pull down, can't enter any data for it, so they would just automatically default to one, which they have their own programs that they use to make these, which are not very user-friendly at all. I couldn't change the colors, I couldn't change the axes, I could not change anything. I just typed in what needed to be typed in, and that's what was, that's what was there. So overall, it was a very positive experience. I gained a lot of professional experience in a working environment. I don't know that it's something I would want to do for the rest of my life, but it was a really good experience. So, are there any questions?
Let's give Kaelin a round of applause.